Welcome back to SWAT Corps, and the big crowd are now going to be entertained by the big bangers. As the V8 supercars start to make their way out, we get a little bit of Bryce on the sideline and everybody ready to go now for Associated Alterations V8 supercars. As you can see there, everything else is only a game, and that's the thing that they've lived for a long, long time. This category going into almost 20 years of racing. And there's some real interesting turnarounds for next year, with Mobil 1 coming on as their main sponsor. It's going to be good to see what's going to happen with all these big contenders fighting it out in arguably some of the fastest cars in the country.
Now, Greg, I have a very important question to ask. What do you think the combined age of the drivers and cars in this class today is?
Yeah, probably about 500 years old. No, only joking. So as they come across the line, it's an inverted grid now for race number two. They go down into turn one and two under double yellow flag, so not overtaking until they actually get out of turn number two. That's when they get the green flag, and then it's everything she's got hammered down. Ooh, Corey Falshink running off the circuit ever so slightly. Cold tyres, Corey, remember that? See if we can keep it all together. JP Norkia around his outside, Isak Spies behind them. Watch out for Thomas Reed. The Cafe 9 Automotive and Coca-Cola Chevy was very quick in the practice session, was qualified on pole. And now we go on board here with Larry Wolford as the green flag comes out.
Yeah, Larry's got to be one of the favourites for this race. Now on the inside already as they're going to turn four. On the inside are two drivers there. That is a very big car to be shoving it on the inside like that. And if one man can do it, it is Larry Wolford to the top of the hill now. You can see the spectators just lined up on the left there. This is one of the classes they've come to see and hear. There's nothing quite like watching a big V8 doing that. Four-wheel steering at the top of turn five.
Well, a little bit of issues there for Terry Wolford. He got out of shape in the Ford Falcon. But if you're a Chevy fan, you're going to be ecstatic. We've got Corvettes 1, 2, and 3. And then you've got the Chevy Lumina on their tail. So the first four cars are all Chevy-powered machines. First of the Ford ones is going to be Di Matteo and then Mackie Adlam on his tail. Those are the two Jaguars coming out of turn eight. On their tail is the third Jag. So you've got literally three Jaguars behind those first four Chevys. Unbelievable start to the second race of V8 Supercars.
Now, Mackie Adlam already starting to make inroads to the front. There's a little bit of contact there going in turn number two. That is between Thomas Reeb and Larry Wolford. So already contact on the second lap of asking here. Said not easy to get these big V8s around SWAT Corps Raceway as we go on board now with Larry Wolford. Going to try and line up a move on the inside. That's coming from miles back. He wasn't going to quite make that stick. Going to try and line up something now. This is the favorite overtaking spot up the hill. Use the horsepower and on the inside of turn five.
And use the white line as well. Remember, Robert, turn five, turn eight, and turn two, white line rule comes into play. So if you go on the right-hand side, you have to stay on the right-hand side of the white line. Just gives you an opportunity to just try something different. And you can see just how hard the trying is coming from both those Jags. Di Matteo and Adlam trying to find a way through. Remember, Adlam just has to finish this race to wrap up the championship. There's a dive on the inside from Thomas Reeb on Wolford. This time it's a bit cleaner. They come out of GNH's corner, and unfortunately, Wolford just had the better line and got better drive there. Here comes Di Matteo though. On the attack, the Italian Stallion looking to get through there and find a way past on Thomas Reeb. Reeb is going defensive every single time because he's got two of those Jaguars right on his tail looking for a way past.
You can see these drivers have to really rear wheel steer the cars through the corners. It's very tight out there. Oh, problems a little bit further back there.
Yeah, Scott Compan pulling onto the left hand side at the exit point of turn number one. Hopefully he'll just get out of harm's way. He does. That's a good bit of driving there. Just keeping the car completely out of harm's way. So no necessity to bring out the Pretoria nor Toyota.
Oh, here we go. Championship starting to heat up now. Mackie Adler must be looking at all the cars around him, thinking all I have to do is finish. Why are you guys doing this to me? But out front, Jamie Norkia in that bright green car. There again, rear wheel steering it to line it up going into turn six. And here comes Thomas Reeb looking very fast and racy at the moment. He's already had contact with Wolford, but starting to get composed and make his way through already in a top three.
No, it's incredible to see how those lock diffs work on these cars with the big V8 power. Diving on the inside, there's a change up. Di Matteo's through on Reeb. Here comes Adlam. Adlam going to try and attack at the same time in the Shell and Auto Adlam machine. He can't find a way past just yet, but he's all over the back there of that Cafe 9 automotive car of Reeb. Reeb has had a fantastic weekend. I don't think he wants to give it up to the champion. He wants to maybe just finish up ahead of the champ. Oh. But the way he's going around the outside, you've got no answer.
Mackie Adlam just kept it pinned and hold fast and went round the outside. Problems here for car 24. That is Johnny Earcote, unfortunately pulling to the side. So we've had some casualties already in the opening couple of laps.
Yeah, Falshink out. We've got Earcote out. We've got Skulky Compan out. And it looks like the lead car there from the start, the prior instrumentation Corvette of Steve Herbst, also starting to fall by the wayside. On board we are with Larry Wolford. There's the white line. Watch for a move on the inside. Yes, Wolford went left. That means he has to stay on the left-hand side of that white line under braking into turn five, and that's allowed Adlam through.
Oh, big wide line there from Thomas Reeb, trying to get the drive. Just locked up the front wheels. A little bit of understeer going into that corner, so wasn't able to bring it into the apex. Again, on board with Larry Wilford. He's starting to drop back a little bit here. Now suffering with problems. Commentator's curse. He spins it around out of the final turn, and that has put an end to any chances he had of trying to get in that top three.
Oh, he's lucky he didn't go into Fermatoville there, because that could have hurt if he'd hit the wall. But now on the inside, what a move from Adlam. That's for the lead. Adlam has got through. Let's have a quick squiz at this maneuver from Wilford. You can see the pressure was on there. I don't know if there was a touch. Oh, there's a little touch. Reeb gives him a little bit of help, but I think he was already sliding before Reeb helped him out. He was already absolutely lit up there, and Reeb just spun him around.
Yeah, just a little tap, that's all it takes. And you can see trying to get that car back on track. But as we said, put an end pretty much to any chances that he had of trying to get. Here we go, on board again. You can see pitches into the final turn. Just gets that little nudge and around she comes. And like I said, did very well to just avoid the other cars and get himself back on track. And all he can hope for now is potentially a top 10.
Isak Spies also having a little bit of issues there to try and avoid the spinning car. But Larry Wilford now get back on track, and let's see what's happening at the front end. Adlam is disappearing. JP Nokia was looking for his first victory ever in a V8. He was going well. And the N4 Autocraft Corvette now in second place. This is the battle for third. Reeb trying to fight off Terry Wilford's attack in the Fuchs lubricants machine as they both go up there. That's Ford versus Chevy, and it's Falcon versus Lumina. Frank DiMatteo looks like he's gone missing. DiMatteo, unfortunately, out of this one as well. So the Italian Stallion in that Deltec Batteries Jaguar has gone.
Mackie Adlam, what a race from the champion. That number one plate is staying put for the 2019 season. And he came from about fourth place, got that big V8 ahead, made some brilliant passes, and he'll cross the line and pick up the win.
And the championship. Fantastic stuff there from Adlam Auto and the Shell car. Mackie Adlam taking the 2018 V8 Supercar Championship. JP Nokia comes through for a second place, his best finish ever in the V8 Supercars. And it's Thomas Reeb in third place, having a phenomenal weekend. Top three there for him. Wilford in fourth, Isak Spies in five, and 20 marks beating out Herbst and Larry Wilford. Let's catch up with your back-to-back champion, Mackie Adlam.
Yes, awesome blessing and an awesome day. Compliments to every driver that was there today, and the second heat was it was amazing. It was so much fun coming from the back, and you know, every driver drove like a star. And yeah, we had a good year.